Hey folks, Darren with Speedway Motors here, continuing our series of videos on how to calibrate our Omega custom gauges here. We're going to go on to the version B style gauge, which is just like this one here. It comes with a set of studs on the back. There's actually only four connections needing to be made on this gauge, as well as an additional connection if you want to have dash lights. This terminal here will be your 12 volt power. This terminal here would be your ground. This is for your signal from your speedometer sender. And then this is your connection for your external push button switch. Now I'm gonna once again hook this up to our simulator unit and we'll go through the programming procedure with that. So we have here just connections here to simulate each terminal on the units. We'll hook up our battery positive. We'll hook up our ground. We're gonna hook up our external push button switch. And then lastly, we will hook up our signal input. Now with these units, you actually have to start with the gauge off and no power running to them. You'll want to hold in the push button and then turn it on. Now once you do that, it'll go to a setup menu, very much like our hello menu from the last video. You'll once again cycle it through until you get to a page here that shows CALDA. It looks like NN, but it's supposed to be calculate drive a mile. You'll once again hold the button in. It'll jump to a series of numbers. The numbers will begin flashing. You'll once again push the button one last time and it will change to zero. You are now in the programming mode. Once again, it only comes down to how long you are driving, or I should say the distance you are driving, and not the amount of time it takes to make that drive. At this point in time, we will hook up our signal generator again, simulating that the vehicle is driving down the road, and we'll once again have it connected for 30 seconds. So while this one runs, you'll actually see that this one actually shows you how many pulses it has seen. Now that is only with these style units, and once again, what the speedometer shows, it does not need to be accurate. It might show anything, it might show nothing. So we're just gonna let this run for 30 seconds, and we'll once again disconnect the unit, and we will finish the programming procedure and then show what it looks like after it's done. As you can see, it's kind of gone backwards and going back around. Not an issue. The gauge itself isn't going to be bad. You haven't damaged anything. That's how this unit is going to operate when you're going through the programming. Now, at this point in time, we're getting pretty close to the end, so we're going to disconnect the connection here. Now, you'll press the button one last time. They once again start to flash. Now, after you have that disconnected or you stop driving that measured mile, you actually just want to power down the unit. Let it sit for about 3-4 seconds, then we will power it back up. We will remake our connection here, and as you can tell, it now displays your correct speed. Once again, these units are dead simple to connect. There's only four connections on the backside of this particular speedometer. If you have any other questions, hit us up in our tech line. Check out our toolbox. You can contact us on our Facebook or YouTube page. Thanks again for joining us here at Speedway Motors, and you have an excellent rest of your day.